Very well. I was looking around here.
I'm the biggest nephew.
But I'm giving it to him, so I'll come back after. Yes, John, I'm giving it to you already, so I will.
Speaker's friend. No. Mr. Speaker, I heard them say speaker's friend. Let me put on record, I'm not the speaker's friend. I'm the speaker's nephew. Please, let's call him.
You're only compounding my problems.
Mr. Speaker, thank you very much. Mr. Speaker, let me commend my brother, the Honorable Suhini, for eulogizing a Pan-Africanist, a man of peace, and a man of many parts. Like my brother Suhini stated, a lot of the celebrities today within the media fraternity had the opportunity of learning under the feet of Mr. Kwesi Senti Bafoboni, popularly known as Babu. I got to meet him when we were in opposition. Somewhere in 2007, I visited Radio Gold. At that time, my brother was representing the MPP on the Alaji and Alaji show. And that was the time I had the opportunity of meeting him. Immediately, I met the Minister for Lands and Natural Resources. Immediately, I met him. We connected. And he told me that he wants to take me as his son. That's because he invited me to his house and we became friends. Indeed, I do recall that when we won power, he played a very, very instrumental role in my appointment. Mr. Speaker, I cannot go into details, but my appointment as special aide to President Mahama was largely influenced by Mr. Bafoboni, and he kept mentoring me. To be frank, before his untimely death, he was in my house that evening. We had dinner together, and then unfortunately, some few days after that, he passed on. I would dearly and greatly miss him. I recall a lot of our travels and how he used to make us smile and laugh on the aircraft with President Mahama. Because I worked with him, he was the most senior most aide in Vice President Mahama's office at that time, and we really, really worked together. The time that I saw his real immense contribution was after the death of President Mills. Indeed, we were not prepared for that circumstance. And so right after President Mills, we needed to do a lot of things. We were also getting into the election. And even at his age, he really, really demonstrated tenacity. Mr. Speaker, we can only learn from his example. We can only learn from some of his good traits. He never got angry. He was a man of peace. And more importantly, he promoted the African culture. I recall that any time we traveled and we're going for an official engagement with President Mahama, he would put on his African wear. And any time we went there, people would be asking where he bought it and how they can get it in Ghana. Mr. Speaker, this tells us something, that death knows no age, it knows no limit, it knows no tribe. And that somehow, some way, all of us would depart this earth. Mr. Speaker, I know that this Saturday is the funeral. I would humbly appeal to all of us, those of us who can be available and those of us who can participate. This is the only opportunity we can go there and show our last respect to our dear father, brother, and colleague. Mr. Speaker, growing up as a boy, my senior brother had bullied me all my life. And I thought in this house, I have the opportunity to liberate myself. But once again, Mr. Speaker, he's had the opportunity to prove that he is senior of the two Jinapos. Mr. Speaker, it's unfortunate. Mr. Speaker, on a more serious note, I met Mr. Bafoboni when I was a panelist on Radio Gold's Alaji and Alaji. And we became very good friends. Mr. Speaker, at the time when you went on this show, Alaji and Alaji, you got into the studio and you will have three NBC panelists, and I happen to always be the only MPP person on the panel. And they had this heavy door, which was like a prison door, which they would slam and close the studio before we start the program. The speaker, but I feel comfortable in the premises of Radio Gold because largely, Mr. Bafokeng will always host me to some drinks, breakfast of a sort, anytime I finished Alaji and Alaji. The speaker, he was a good man, and on many occasions, I will also insist that he joins me to enjoy some MPP food. And on some rare occasions, he will follow me to the residence of the late Honorable Victor Newman, and then we'll have watching together, and we'll have a lot of chat. So, Speaker, I rise to contribute to this statement and to pay tribute to Mr. Kwesi Sintim Hafubone solely on the ground of his bipartisanship. In spite of his strong attachment to the National Democratic Congress, I found him to be somebody who was very prepared to engage with people from the other side of the political divide. And I think that's a good thing, and we should applaud him for that kind of conduct. Mr. Speaker, I will say that Mr. Bafokeng was indeed a very good friend of mine. I'd known him for all these years, and we had engaged very closely over the years. And I found him to be a good human being, a good person, who did not discriminate against people on political lines. Mr. Speaker, today we've lost him. We are in this house to pay tribute to him. And I believe that one of the things which goes for him strongly is the fact that he was a bipartisan individual. Mr. Speaker, with these few words, I join my colleagues in paying glorious tribute to Mr. Kwesi Sintim Bafokeng.